Welcome class 10th. Here I am going to continue chapter 7, Glimpses of India. And hereby we will start part 2, Coorg by Lokesh Abrol. Let's get the introduction of the chapter. In the second part of the chapter, Glimpses of India, you are going to know about the beautiful insight of the smallest district of Karnataka, that is Coorg, and its wonderful people. The place has an amazing weather throughout the year, with enough rain during the monsoon season. The people of Coorg are known to be one of the bravest people in the world. Coffee is the main crop grown in this region. A variety of animals can also be found here, while the place is surrounded by the beautiful Brahmagiri hills, islands and Tibetan settlements. Let's know. The author Lokesh Abrol is a renowned doctor by profession. He has established the first multi-speciality hospital in the private sector in Gurgaon. He is also a social worker. He has also established the first stray cow shelter in Gurgaon. He is also the established writer. This essay on Coorg highlights his sharp observation and the ability for a graphic description of the wonderful land that's called Coorg. See the chapter Coorg. Coorg is coffee country, famous for its rainforest and spices. This chapter belongs to Coorg, that is a coffee producing area in the Karnataka state of India. It's situated midway between Mysore and the coastal town of Mangalore. This land is famous for its rainforest and spices. Glimpses of India, part 2, Coorg. Let's see the chapter. Midway between Mysore and the coastal town of Mangalore sits a piece of heaven that must have drifted from the kingdom of God. Drifted from, that means carried along gently by air. In this narrative, the writer Lokesh Abrol has given the graphic description about a wonderful hill station that is located in the Western Ghats in the state of Karnataka. This is Coorg. While describing the beauty and splendor of Coorg, writer explains, Coorg is so beautiful that it seems that it is a piece of heaven that has drifted away from the God's kingdom and has settled over here on the earth. This place is located somewhere between Mysore and Bangalore. This land of rolling hills is inhabited by proud race of martial men, beautiful women and wild creatures. Martials stand for warlike or brave. Here, the writer says, as the area is surrounded with the low hills of unequal height, that's why Coorg is also called the land of rolling hills. The place is inhabited by proud race of martial men and beautiful women. Along with, the place has variety of wild animals due to the extension of forest land in Coorg. Coorg or Kodagu, the smallest district of Karnataka, is home to evergreen rainforest, spices and coffee plantation. Here it is mentioned, Coorg is also known as Kodagu. It is one of the smallest district of Karnataka, but is the home to evergreen rainforest, spices and coffee plantations. And evergreen rainforest cover 30% of this districts, and 30% of the area of Coorg is covered with evergreen rainforest. During the monsoons, it pours enough to keep
many visitors away.
Coorg is a place that receives rain for most part of the year. But during the monsoon season, this rain becomes the hurdle for the visitors to keep away from this beautiful place. The season of joy commences from September and continues till March. But the period from the month of September till March is the ideal time for visiting Coorg. The weather is perfect with some showers thrown in for good measure. The air breathes of invigorating coffee. Invigorating, that means giving energy. Hence, it is explained, this period between September till March, the weather is so pleasant over here that if there is some rain, it makes the weather worthwhile. The air is filled with the strong fragrance of coffee all over the place due to the coffee plantation over this region. Coffee estates and colonial bungalows stand tucked under tree canopies in prime corners. Colonial bungalows stand for the big houses which are made during the colonial rule of the British in our country. Tucked, that means placed. Tree canopies, that means covered tent of the trees. Here you can see in Coorg the coffee estates and the colonial bungalows are scattered all around the tree canopies in all the prime corners of this small district. The fiercely independent people of Coorg are possibly of Greek or Arabic descent. Fiercely stands for very strongly, descent, that means origin. Here it is mentioned that the people of Coorg are believed to be of Greek or Arabic background and are generally very strong and ferocious. As one story goes, a part of Alexander's army moved south along the coast and settled here. One return became impractical. Impractical, that means not possible. It is rumored that when great Alexander's army had moved to the south for extending its territory over there, due to some reason, some of his army men could not return due to some impractical ways. Then these people married amongst the locals, and the culture is apparent in the martial traditions, marriage and religious rites, which are distinct from the Hindu mainstream. Apparent, that means clear. Martial, that means warlike or brave. Rites, that means rituals. Distincts, that means different. Mainstream, that means main tradition. These leftover people of Alexander's army had married to the locals, but their culture is quite evident in their war skills, in the marriages and the other religious customs and traditions, which are quite different from the mainstream of the Hindu tradition and culture. The theory of Arab origin draws support from the long black coat with an embroidered waist belt worn by the Kudaus, known as kufia. It resembles the kufia worn by the Arabs and Kurds. Another story which support their Arabic background is because of their dressing style. You can see these Kadaus, that means the residents of Coorg, generally wearing long and black coat with embroidered waist belt, which is known as kufia. Kufia is similar to the kufia worn by the Arabs and the Kurds. Hence, from their dressing style and their tradition and the rites, we come to know the people of Coorg are believed to be of Greek or Arabic origin.
Kurgi homes have a tradition of hospitality, and they are more than willing to recount numerous tales of valor related to their own sons and fathers. Hospitality, that means serve the guest. Recount means narrate. Tales means stories. Valor means bravery. Here it is mentioned that the Kurgi people, they are warm in nature. They are good in hospitality. They are always ready to entertain the people with the stories of bravery of their ancestors, their sons and their fathers. The Kurg regiment is one of the most decorated in the Indian Army, and the first chief of the Indian Army, General Karyappa, was a Kurgi. Even now, Kudaus are the only people in India permitted to carry firearms without a license. Firearm means guns.
Here it is mentioned that the strength and bravery of the Kurg people is quite evident from the fact that the Kurg regiment in the Indian Army has received the maximum number of awards for the bravery. The first chief of the Indian Army, named General Karyappa, belonged to Kurg. It is also not hidden the fact from anyone that only the Kurgian people are permitted to carry firearms, that means guns, freely without license. This shows the valor and reliability of this community. The river Kaveri obtains its water from the hills and forest of Kurg. Mahasir, a large freshwater fish, abound in these waters. So here it is explained that the Kurg is the home for the large number of wild animals and birds. So this place is full of natural beauty. The evergreen forest and the hills of the Kurg provide water to the river Kaveri. That is a major river in the South India. Kingfishers dive for their catch, while squirrels and langurs drop partially eaten fruit for the mischief of enjoying the splash and the ripple effect in the clear water. Mischief means playful manner. Ripple effect, that is a small wave or the series of waves on the surface of water, especially that is caused by the slight breeze or an object dropping into the water. Even the kingfishers, they like to dive freely in the water. Along with squirrels and langurs, they also like to play in the clear water by throwing their half-eaten fruit and thus producing the splashing and rippling effect in the clear water. Elephants enjoy being bathed and scrubbed in the river by their mahouts. Mahouts are the persons who works and take care of the elephant. Hence, wild animals also enjoy being bathed and scrubbed in the river by their mahouts. The most laid-back individuals become converts to the life of high energy adventure with river rafting, canoeing, rappelling, rock climbing and mountain biking. Laid-back, that means relax, not in a hurry. Rafting, that means travel in a river in a raft, that is a floating platform made by tying the planks together. Canoeing, that means traveling in a river in a canoe, that is a large narrow boat. Rappelling, that means going down a cliff by sliding down a rope. Here it is mentioned, even the relaxed mood or the laziest tourist, when they come to Kurg, they also become adventurous, as the place is full of adventurous sports like river rafting, canoeing, rappelling, rock climbing and mountain biking. Numerous walking trails in this region are a favorite with trekkers. Trails means paths created by walking. However, The footsteps of the walkers have formed the various paths over the hills for the tracking. Hence, the place has turned to be a favorite among the trackers. Birds, bees, and butterflies are there to give you company. Macaws, Malabar squirrels, langurs, and slender loris keep a watchful eye from the tree canopy. I do, however, prefer to step aside for wild elephants. Here the writer says, while taking a walk in this region, one may find a variety of birds and animals around them. These birds, bees, and butterflies fly around you, while macaws, Malabar squirrels, langurs, and slender loris, all these animals would keep an eye on you from the trees. Even wild animals can also be found in the Kurk. So be very careful while taking the round in this region. The climb to the Brahmagiri Hills brings you into a panoramic view of the entire misty landscape of Kurk. Panoramic view means a large and a wider view of the land. Misty means full of fog. Landscape means scenery. So here it is concluded to have the overall look of this foggy but beautiful city of Kurk, one must have to climb up to the Brahmagiri Hills. A walk across the rope bridge leads to the 64-acre islands of Nisargadham, running into Buddhist monks from India's largest Tibetan settlement at nearby Baila Kupe is a bonus. However, Kurk is a beautiful place surrounded by astounding places of beauty like the island of Nisargadham and Baila Kupe, which is India's largest Tibetan settlement. That is the extra reward of the beauty would be enjoyed by the tourist. The monks in red ochre and yellow robes are amongst the many surprises that wait to be discovered by visitors searching for the heart and soul of India right here in Kurk. Ochre, that is the yellowish orange color. Robes, that means dresses. Moreover, the monks wearing red, orange and yellow colored robes or the garments can also be viewed in the district of Kurk, whose lifestyle can be the fascinating view for the tourist who are in the search of the heart and soul of India. Hence, the mixture of diverse cultures can easily be found in this district of Kurk. Hence, from the explanation, we come to know that the nature is in its pristine form in Kurk. Narrator has described, if we want to visit the place, the distance from Bangalore is around 250 to 60 km only. So go and enjoy the beauty and splendor of the nature. I hope you well understood the explanation. Thank you for watching the video.